name and I drove on the Danville train till so much cavalry came and tore up the tracks again.
In the late 60s, a artist looked back into American's past and helped nurture a new musical direction. The song "The Night They Drove Old Dixie Down" by the band, which was the result of Robbie Robertson's research of our American Civil War history. It came to respect for Robert E. Lee and the people of the American Southland. Robbie Robertson took on this event that ripped our nation apart with the song "The Night They Tore Old Dixie Down." My name is Gregory Newsom. I'm the creator of this June 2018 to December 2019 CSA American Civil War calendar, which celebrates the integrated armies of Thomas Stonewall Jackson and Nathan Bedford Forrest. I'm very fortunate as an African American artist and writer to be able to practice my freedom of speech rights, which is to protest against the historical vandalism aimed at Southern culture. For the last 5 years, I've been touring Civil War reenactments and living history events, making available my calendar, written and illustrated graphic novel books, and print artwork for homes and businesses to display. American Civil War history is being intentionally eliminated from your children's education because telling the truth now after falsely teaching could be a great embarrassment to our government and its institutions. But in my opinion, the real truth would set us all free from bias and prejudice. I do not believe in sitting back safely in my art studio and executing artwork that contribute to my series of CSA buried treasure books and other products. I believe in taking my artwork to Civil War reenactments and living history events all over the country. I'm also celebrating like-minded people like H.K. Etchison, who is on the cover of my CSA calendar, and Teresa Rowan, mentioned in the interior of this CSA calendar. This calendar is 9 by 12 inches, fully illustrated by me, Gregory Newsom. The calendar highlights dates that Stonewall Jackson and the misunderstood Nathan Bedford Forrest took integrated armies into the battlefield, contrary to what we were taught, that the Confederate Afro-American soldier was only used as cooks, teamsters, orderlies, and flunky. But your school books are absent of the fact that the Northern Union armies used the Afro-American soldier as shock troops. This was one of the reasons for segregated Union armies. This video shows you all the pages that are in the catalog and with dates of when Thomas Stonewall Jackson and Nathan Bedford Forrest took their Confederate integrated armies into battle against the segregated Northern Army. You may ask, how did I get on this path as an artist? Well, 15 years ago, I was searching for a subject to paint and discovered a person that led me to a thought-provoking topic by accident. Thomas Stonewall Jackson defied Virginia law by teaching Afro-American slaves how to read and write and started the first Sunday school and supported it with part of his paycheck from the Civil War battlefields as he was doing battle against Union forces to keep it open. No one exemplifies this kind of courage better than Dr. Martin Luther King, who said, "Cowards ask the question, is it safe? Expedients ask the question, is it political? Vanity asks the question, is it popular? But conscience asks the question, is it right? And there comes a time when one must take a position that is neither safe, nor political, nor popular. But one must take it simply because it is right. Dr. King's very words. My graphic novel books, calendars, and artwork unintentionally represents Robbie's and Mr. King's courage. This calendar I hope you will consider to display in your households and places of business. But your financial support will give me more passion for getting out the truth. Thank you for your support.